My name is Laura, and I'm on the Chrome accessibility team at Google. In this video, I'm going to show you some of the built-in features on your Chromebook that may help if you find it difficult to use your touchpad or type on the physical keyboard. To get started, let's open up the Chromebook accessibility settings. To get started, I open the Chrome OS settings page and go to the accessibility section. To do this, I press Alt-Shift-S or click the status tray in the lower right-hand corner and choose Settings. Now I can either click on the Advanced Settings link at the bottom of the page and then scroll down a little, or I can simply type Accessibility into the search field. First, I'm going to turn on Sticky Keys. Sticky means that when I use the keyboard shortcuts, I can type keys in sequence so I don't have to hold them down. This is helpful if you use the keyboard with only one hand. These keys are Control, Alt, Shift, and Search. Most Chromebook shortcuts start with one of these. Notice that as I press the keys, a small box appears on the screen and spotlighting shows which sticky keys I've pressed so far. I can even use sticky keys to write text. Say I want to type in all caps. With sticky keys on, I press Shift 2 times. In the box on the left, the highlighted key is now underlined. If I want to make a pressed key unsticky, I press it a 3rd time. Now both the spotlighting and underlining are gone. Next, I'm going to turn on tap dragging, which is pretty much how it sounds, using your finger on the touchpad to drag different items on the screen. This is particularly helpful if it's a challenge to physically push down on the touchpad in order to click or move items around the screen. Before I start to use tap dragging, I want to make sure that the tap to click setting is on, as these two features work hand in hand. So I go to the Chrome OS settings again, and under Devices, I click Touchpad Settings. The box for tap to click is checked, so I'm good to go. With this setting, I can lightly tap my finger on the touchpad to click an object without having to put physical pressure down on the trackpad. Next, I make sure tap dragging is selected under Accessibility Settings. Now, if I want to rearrange icons on the shelf in the lower left-hand corner, for example, I tap my finger on the touchpad once to select an icon, and then right away, tap my finger again, this time leaving my finger pressed on the trackpad. And now I drag my finger to move it. This is basically a double tap and drag. Another built-in accessibility feature is automatic clicks. With automatic clicks, I can use my mouse cursor to navigate to something that's clickable on the screen, and then if I hover over that item for a given amount of time, Chrome OS will click it for me. This way, I don't have to use any physical pressure on the touchpad or on my mouse itself in order to click. I can turn it on by clicking the checkbox, and then I hover my mouse pointer over the button to customize how long it pauses. Notice it opens the menu and blue and green circles target where Chrome OS is going to click. In high contrast mode, they may look purple and yellow. As I move along the settings page, note how automatic clicking can help me click checkboxes too. I'll go ahead and turn this off for now. Now I want to show you a few settings for your physical keyboard. First, let's open up the Chrome OS settings. Then I scroll down and open the keyboard settings. This is where I can adjust the keyboard repeat rate. With this, I can adjust how long I need to press a key before it repeats, how fast the key press should repeat, or even turn off auto-repeat so that I have to press a key each time. Okay, I'm going to open up the Chrome OS settings again, then click Show Advanced Settings, and click Language and Input Settings. From here, I'll click this Configure button. Here, I can turn on features like auto capitalization and word prediction. First, I have to make sure I've turned autocorrection on. Notice that I can choose whether autocorrection should be set to modest or aggressive. Word prediction and auto capitalization can help me type faster and more accurately by reducing how much typing I have to do. When suggestions are available, like when typing in a Gmail draft, an underline with an arrow will appear. I can press the down arrow to view the suggestions and press Enter to accept. Note that this functionality doesn't yet work within G Suite apps. Word prediction and auto capitalization are also available in this next feature, our on-screen keyboard. Let's open that up now. In the Chrome OS settings, I click this checkbox and a small icon appears at the bottom of my Chromebook screen. Pressing this icon opens up the keyboard. It also automatically appears when my cursor is in a text entry field. Now, I can use the mouse to type, or if I have a touch screen, I can also use my fingers or another pointing device. To turn on word prediction and auto correction, I open up the Chrome OS settings again, then show advanced settings, then click on the language and input settings again, and click that configure button one more time. The virtual keyboard has its own settings, so even if you turn these functions on for your physical keyboard, you still have to turn them on for the virtual keyboard. The virtual keyboard also works well with those sticky keys I showed you earlier. While this is open, there's one last feature I want to show you, and that's voice input. You'll need the virtual keyboard open in order to access it. I simply click on the microphone icon in the upper right-hand corner of the on-screen keyboard, and then I speak to input text. When it's on, I can speak to enter text, like in a Gmail message. Note that Google Docs has its own built-in dictation and voice commands called voice typing. It's a little bit more robust for writing documents, so I definitely recommend checking it out. So, we covered a handful of different features to make your physical keyboard and touchpad easier to use. Did you see any that you find helpful? To provide our team with feedback or ask us questions about any of the topics you've seen today, join our Google group and send us an email at chromebook-accessibility@googlegroups.com. If you have any questions about Google accessibility as a whole, find out more at google.com/accessibility. To sign up for user studies to explore new features and help shape Google products, visit us at google.com/usability. Also, look out for other videos for more ways to make Chrome and Chromebooks easier to use. Again, I'm Laura, and on behalf of myself and the Chrome accessibility team, thanks for watching. And don't forget, we have a handful of other videos about Chrome accessibility. Check them out here.